Hi everyone, Creepthany O'Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new Ghost album, Prequel. This is the latest full-length album, the fourth full-length album from Swedish metal outfit Ghost. One of my most anticipated records of the year, not just because I thought the band's last album, Meliora, is their best so far, but also it is one of my favorite metal records of the decade. My excitement for this album runs so deep, I went into the band's latest record with some reservations, kind of worrying about how the band was going to follow this record up. How could they top the anthemic and triumphant songwriting of this record, the wonderfully devilish, religious, blasphemous, and occult themes in the lyrics? The beautiful instrumental layering, too. Sure, this record is a lot less edgy than Ghost's debut album, but I felt like the band built on their sound really creatively to get to this point. They also had bounced back from their near-horrendous sophomore album, Infestissimum, where the band had kind of transitioned from being this creepy heavy metal revivalist outfit to a rock band that sounded almost like a novelty, like that one track on here that has like almost a circus music vibe still haunts me to this day. One more thing that had me worried going into this record is that a bunch of members of the band left Anonymous Ghouls and sued the band's founder, Tobias Forge, over money issues, and these band members also decried Tobias framing Ghost as a bit of a solo venture with like hired musicians surrounding him, as opposed to a fully artistically collaborative band. So going into this record, you're talking about a lineup change that could affect the dynamic creativity of Ghost in a huge way. I figured there was almost something up with that when I was sort of underwhelmed by teaser tracks to this album like Rats and Dance Macabre, whose subtle hair metal nods were a huge turnoff for me on first listen. So I kind of went into this thing thinking it was going to be a bore and Ghost were essentially just going to be treading water, but I actually enjoyed this album a lot. I kind of love it. I think this record may end up being a little bit of a split for Ghost fans so far, but for the most part, I think the band continues to deliver what has made them entertaining up until this point. What might get the goat of some Ghost fans is that this record is not quite as aggressive as their past several releases, not as heavy, not as sinister in some regards. And sure, while on this album I think Ghost are still very much a metal band at their core, they work in a lot of elements of arena rock and pop and progressive rock and hard rock on this thing. There's even a goddamn sax solo at the end of the song Miasma. So this time around, Ghost are sounding lighter and brighter, but for me that's not necessarily a knock against this album. I don't think the band has really kind of stepped over an unforgivable line or anything like that, because extremity and aggression has never really been Ghost's true selling point. In fact, like, what made them so exciting to begin with is that they were going against the grain of the trend of extremity going on in underground metal, and they were going back to the basics of tunes and songwriting and melody, and delivering all of that with a fair amount of camp and drama. And the band continues to do that on this new record over here, pulling on heavy metal and hard rock legends like Black Sabbath and Alice Cooper, Mercyful Fate. There are moments on this record that are kind of sweet to the ear, like an old school pop record. Occasionally, the instrumentation on this record is grand and ambitious, like a Pink Floyd or a David Bowie record. And there's also a subtly grim element to the band sound, too. Obviously, they pull quite a bit from the old school of black metal, whose theatrics often go underappreciated, though they have clearly had a huge impact on Ghost's presentation. On this one, I think Ghost effectively turn up the anthems, turn up the camp, turn up the cheese. It's going to be irresistible for fans who enjoy that element of their music, but maybe a breaking point for those who find the approach they're taking here kind of corny. But if you prefer your metal music to be more self-serious and abrasive, you probably haven't been enjoying much of Ghost's music up until this point anyway. The first big song on this record is Rats, which again was a teaser track to this album and was a huge turnoff for me on first listen. My first impression was that it sounded like Ghost kind of painting themselves into a corner artistically, but with repeated listens, the lead vocal melody, the guitar riffs, they have left an impression on me, a distinct impression. I find the bright choral vocals and shiny keyboards on the hook to be stunning. The raspy proclamation of rats on the chorus as well is a little hokey, but I do kind of love the the playful, spooky vibe that it brings. The band's new frontman, Cardinal Copia, of course, sings in the group's typically very boyish, clean, and angelic vocal style. The instrumentation is just orgasmically dark and melodic. There's a heavy, badass riff right at the finish of the song, a beautifully harmonized guitar solo. I love the exciting performance, the slick production, the structure of the track. Right after this song is usually where Ghost will try to fit a barn burner into the first leg of the album, and the song Faith is essentially that. It's got a great, crushing riff coming right off that intro, but it mostly feels like a moment of deja vu for me. This is very much a From the Pinnacle to the Pit and Circe type moment. So while the track to me doesn't strike me as one of Ghost's more original or memorable tracks, I have to admit that it does help the flow of the album. It doesn't sound bad. I did have kind of a Pavlovian desire to hear a track just like this at this point on the album, which I don't know if that says more about me or how great the band are at structuring albums that I just continue to expect them to do it mostly the same way. If there are a few things that make this song stand out, it's the refreshingly demonic vocal bridge. And just the production generally making the band sound larger than life. At this point on the LP, I would expect the band to slow things down, bring a ballad, but thankfully they don't give into that, break that up with the song See the Light. A track that comes off like a really grand piece of arena rock, progressive rock, with a swaying groove. Very unsettling lyrics with Cardinal Copia singing about growing stronger off of hate. There's also a standout lyric with him singing about befriending rats that seemed like a conscious reference to the turmoil the band had recently gone through. I mean, you could chalk it up to another God versus Satan moment, or maybe he's literally talking about rats, as the main theme, the concept of this album, focuses on medieval times, the bubonic plague, but the tone of the lyrics just seems a little too personal for it to be just yet another piece of religious or historical allegory in Ghost's music. Though there is plenty of that here as well on this track, with lyrics like, drink me, eat me, then you'll see the light, obviously bringing up those religious themes, but with, of course, an occult twist. I love the heavy guitar riffs on this thing, the soaring lead guitars, the glistening pianos, it's all epic as hell. Then there's a very exciting and fun instrumental cut in the midst of the record with Miasma, and it's just a really exhilarating and fantastically paced jam with amazing synth solos and that sax bit I mentioned earlier that adds a lot to the song. The song Dance Macabre was a huge turnoff for me when I first heard it. I was like, what is going on here? Is this like a crappy, corny, poppy love song? But as I listened to it more, I kind of got the genius of the track, not only in how it fits into the overall theme, the concept of the record, but also the band wrote a song that sounds on the surface like a very poppy, lovesick rock tune, but it still fits into their repertoire. The driving kick drum and the wailing catchy riffs are very sweet to the ear, but there is that organ kind of hanging in the background, making things a little eerie. And while there are lyrics on this thing about kissing under the moonlight, that is also juxtaposed against lyrics about this potentially being the last time you can do that, death creeping around the corner as a result of this plague. Deeper into the chorus, we have these lyrics that at first sound like, I want to be with you all night. It kind of sounds like something out of a righteous hair metal tune, but what's actually being said is, I want to bewitch you all night. I should have known, those organ chords, they were sounding kind of witchy. And along with these medieval and black death themes that run throughout the record, there are quite a few nods to witches and magic as well, of course. What's not so genius on the album is the song Pro Memoria, which has a lovely string intro and a grand cinematic instrumental presentation. Also, some of the creepiest intro lyrics on the entire record. Lucifer whispering silently in your mind, who walks behind, standing tall, invincible, but do not forget your knives to save your lives, to save your lives. But then the lyrics devolve into this tactless, weirdly, awkwardly blunt refrain that is repeated multiple times across the track. Don't you forget about dying. Don't you forget about your friend death. Don't you forget that you will die. Like, wow. I get how this song plays and into the plague themes of the album. I actually love the instrumental on the track quite a bit, but I think this chorus could have used a lyrical rework. It really could have been put more poetically. It sounds like something out of like a bad theater production. Don't you forget about dying. Don't you forget about your friend death. The song Witch Image is a much better tune, even though in the intro there are kind of these very dissonant, sour, weird synth chords kind of wailing away in the background annoyingly. This track doesn't feel like arena rock as much as it feels like blackened cathedral rock. A lot of the singing on the track seems to be done from the standpoint of the Grim Reaper.
Ooh.
With a hilarious juxtaposition in the chorus of somebody sleeping in earthly delight while another person is laying there with their flesh rotting off. This track is followed with yet another grand synth-strumental, not quite as exciting as Miasma, felt kind of unnecessary at this point, honestly, especially since it's not that much different in tone than the previous instrumental track. Like, it's a bit easier on the ears and a bit moodier. It's a passable moment, it works into the flow of the record, but it still feels like the band is kind of stretching the sound of this album thin. They're kind of packing some time in to make sure that they hit that 40-minute mark. The closer is really strong, though, one of the most catchy and passionate tunes on the entire record, and it's actually quite haunting as well. It really kind of leaves the record off on a spooky cliffhanger that I love a lot. Overall, I pretty much love this album. There are so many great tracks on this thing, good flow, fantastic production, fantastic songwriting, some of the band's best material to date. Even if it is a bit sweeter, a bit poppier, sure, there are a few tracks that pale in comparison to others, and I will say, though I appreciate the themes that run throughout this record, I feel like it's maybe a little too generous to call this a concept album. If so, I think the band could have easily gone into these medieval themes, the Black Plague themes, the dying themes, the effect of all these things in a much more detailed fashion. I mean, they're definitely present, they add a lot of character to the record, they break up the monotony of what you would typically hear lyrically on a Ghost album, but don't go into this thing assuming you're gonna hear some kind of grand narrative or story album or something like that. Unfortunately, even though it seems like there is a lyrical focus on this record, Ghost have fallen pretty short of that. I'm feeling a light to decent 8 on this thing. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Just leave a comment in the comments if you're feeling like you're full of thoughts. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Ghost forever.